Students, so today let's look at the fifth part of our story, The Tiger King. The Maharaja's anxiety reached a fever pitch when there remained just one tiger to achieve his tally of 100. So till we know that the Maharaja has killed 99 tigers and he was to kill just one more to complete his total of 100 tigers, and now he became very anxious and curious to kill the 100th tiger. He had this one thought during the day and the same dream at night. By this time the tiger farm's heart run dry even in his father-in-law's kingdom. It became impossible to locate tigers anywhere, yet only one more was needed. If he could kill just that one single beast, the Maharaja would have no fears left. He could give up tiger hunting altogether. So there is only one tiger left to be killed, and all through the day and night the Maharaja kept on dreaming of killing the 100th tiger. And the tiger population in the king's father-in-law's kingdom had also finished, and he could not find a single tiger anywhere to kill. He was very desperate for that one single tiger that he could hunt, after which he would give up hunting, as he would not fear tigers any longer. It was a prediction that if the death of the Tiger King would come from a tiger and from the 100th tiger. So if he could be able to kill 100 tiger, then there will be no fear for him. That is why he is so anxious and so desperate to kill the 100th tiger. But he had to be extremely careful with that last tiger. What had the late chief astrologer said? Even after killing 99 tigers, the Maharaja should beware of the 100. So the Maharaja would be very careful with the 100th tiger, because it was told by the chief astrologer that the Maharaja has to be very careful of the 100th tiger. True enough, the tiger was a savage beast after all. One had to be wary of it. But where was that 100th tiger to be found? It seemed easier to find tiger's meal than a leaf tiger. So the Maharaja, he was reminded of the astrologer's prediction that the Tiger King should be very careful of the 100th tiger. But he was not able to find the 100th tiger anywhere. The writer creates humor here by saying that it is easier to find even tiger's milk in the kingdom rather than an alive tiger. Thus the Maharaja was sunk in gloom. The Maharaja became very sad. But soon came the happy news which dispelled that gloom. But there was a happy news for him. What was that news? In his own stead, sheep began to disappear frequently from a hillside village. So there was a hope that there may be a tiger, because in a hillside village, some sheep began to disappear frequently. It was first ascertained that this was not the work of Khader Mia Saheb or Birasami Nagar, both famed for their ability to swallow sheep whole. Surely a tiger was at work. The villagers ran to inform the Maharaja. The Maharaja announced a 3-year exemption from all taxes for that village and set out on the hunt at once. So it was first ascertained that this was not work of Khader Mia Saheb or Birasami Nagar. Who was Khader Mia Saheb or Birasami Nagar? They were both famous for the ability to swallow sheep whole. So when the king became very sad that there is no tiger and he could not find the 100 tiger anywhere, then he became very upset. Then the happy news came that in a village, in a hillside village, there was some sheep began to disappear in that village, and it was the happy news for that king, for the Maharaja. There are two people named Khader Mia Sahib and Birasami Naikar. They could swallow whole sheep, and that is why they are famous. But it was ascertained that this is not their job, this is not done by them, and so it was calculated that there was a tiger at work. The villagers were very excited and they informed the king about it. The Maharaja was so happy that he exempted the villagers from all taxes for 3 years and set out to hunt tiger. So for 3 years, the Maharaja announced exemption from all tax for the village. The tiger was not easily found. It seemed as if it had suddenly hit itself in order to flout the Maharaja's will. So the Maharaja was determined to kill that tiger, but what happened? The tiger was not easily found. As they passed, the Maharaja was very angry. The Maharaja equally determined, he refused to leave the forest until the tiger was found. So he was searching, he was in the forest, but for the tiger, to find the tiger and kill it, but the tiger was not found there, and the Maharaja refused to leave the forest until he could kill the tiger. As the days passed, the Maharaja's fury and obstinacy mounted alarmingly. Many officers lost their jobs. So as they passed, the tiger was not found, and the Maharaja became so angry. One day, his rake was at its head. The Maharaja called the Diwan and ordered him to double the land tax forthwith. So, one day he became so angry. Then he called the minister, the Diwan, and ordered him to increase the land tax to double. Earlier, the village was exempted. The village people were exempted from the tax, and now he increased the land tax to double. He felt that by doing this, the people would become unhappy and his kingdom would become a part of here. The people will become discontented, then our state too will fall a prey to the Indian National Congress. So the Diwan, the minister, was in fear that the people, the villagers will become so dissatisfied, disappointed, and the state too will fall into the prey of Indian National Congress. In that case, you may resign from your post. But the king, the Maharaja, was so determined that he did not think about it, and he told the minister that you could resign from your job. The Maharaja threatened the minister. The Diwan went home convinced that if the Maharaja did not find the tiger soon, the results could be catastrophic. He felt that life returning to him only when he saw the tiger, which had been brought from the People's Park in Madras and kept hidden in his house. So, the minister, he found the tiger that had been brought from the People's Park in Madras and was hidden in his house. He felt relieved. At midnight, when the town slept in peace, the Diwan and his aged wife dragged the tiger to the car and shoved it into the seat. The Diwan himself drove the car straight to the forest where the Maharaja was hunting. When they reached the forest, The tiger launched its satyagraha and refused to get out of the car. The Diwan was thoroughly exhausted in his efforts to hold the beast out of the car and push it down to the ground. The minister, along with his wife, pulled the tiger into his car and drove the car to the forest where the Maharaja was hunting. The tiger did not come out of the car, and the minister had tough time pushing the tiger out of the car into the forest. So the Diwan was pushing the tiger into the forest from the car, but it is not violent. That is why the writer said that it launched its satyagraha, because the tiger is not so violent. On the following day, the same tiger wandered into the Maharaja's presence, stood as if in humble supplication. "Master, what could you comment of me?" It was with boundless joy which the Maharaja took careful aim at the beast. The tiger fell in a crumpled heap. So the next day, the tiger was spotted by the Maharaja in the forest, and it was taken by the Diwan himself. He was so happy to see the 100 tiger and aimed at the tiger. He was so happy, aimed at the tiger. The tiger fell down as if it had been shot dead by the king. He was so overwhelmed to kill the tiger and had fulfilled his vow to kill the 100 tiger. The Maharaja is so happy. "I have killed the 100 tiger. My vow has been fulfilled." The Maharaja was overcome with elation, ordering the tiger to be brought to the capital in grand procession. The Maharaja hastened away in his car. So the Maharaja is so happy, he ordered to bring the tiger, the dead tiger, to the capital in grand procession. And then, saying it, he left in his car. After the Maharaja left, the hunters went to take a closer look at the tiger. The tiger looked back at him, rolling its eyes in bafflement. The man realized that the tiger was not dead. The bullet had missed it. It had fainted from the shock of the whizzing past. The hunters wondered what they should do. So, after that, the king had left, and the hunters took a closer look to the tiger, and they saw that it was alive. It is not dead. The Maharaja was not able to kill it. He only fainted because of the bullet passed close to it. The hunters were so confused what to do, and they aimed at the tiger and shot dead. The hunters, they decided that the Maharaja must not come to know that they had missed his tiger. If he did, they could lose their jobs. So if the Maharaja knew this incident, that he had missed the target, then he will be very angry, and the soldiers, they would lose their jobs. That is why one of the hunters took aim from a distance and shot the tiger. This time he killed it without missing his mark. So it is not the Tiger King, it is not the Maharaja, but one of the hunters killed the 100 tiger. Then, as commanded by the king, the dead tiger was taken in procession through the town and buried. A tomb was erected over it. So, as commanded, as ordered by the king, the dead tiger was taken in great procession through the town, and it was buried, and a tomb was erected over it. So, it is about the killing of the 100 tiger. The 100 tiger was not killed by the Maharaja, but the Maharaja is so happy, thinking that he had killed 100 tiger, and there is no fear for his life. The prediction that the chief astrologer made for the death of the Tiger King, for the death of the Maharaja, it is not fulfilled, it is not successful, and the Maharaja is able to kill 100 tiger. So he would now stop his tiger hunt.